Hello, my name is Anthony Hall and this is a basic tutorial on how to use weight maps with instancing. So let me just explain my objects that I'm going to make a scene from. So I've got this basic land plane, and what all this is I've kind of sculpted out a little stream with a mud bank and some grass, and this is done in Mudbox and then exported as an OBJ, or you can do it as an FBX, it's up to you. And then I've done this one as an OBJ, so when I brought it in, I've had to just attach the... There's only two maps. There's a diffuse map, which is a colour map, and then a bump map. So FBX is sometimes, or more likely when you bring them in, they'll automatically plug in them for you. However, they do them as a standard shader, not a PBR one. So as well as this land, I've got some other items. I've got some different trees that I've collected off the internet, three different trees, some short grass, long grass, a type of weed, a rock, and then here's my land. So what I want to do is I want to use instancing to place these different trees and grass to come up with a little scene, like a nature scene. However, I don't so I can control the actual way the instance is spread over my land, I'm going to use weight maps to actually assign the instances to. So the first thing I need to do is actually make some weight maps. So in my top view, the best thing to do is using the points is if you right mouse click, you can lasso around an area that you want to make the weight map from. So say I wanted this area, and then if I hold shift on my keyboard and let's say this area, I could say that was one weight map, and then I could simply go down to the bottom corner here which says weight maps. I've already created some. Go new, and you would give it a name and press create. And when you do that, under your vertex maps here where it says weight, it adds your actual weight maps here. Look, so I've got four, so, and that's just by using lasso tool, or like I said, if you hold down, you can hold down shift, you can select randomly where you want the weight to actually be. So to view your weight maps, if you go up to the top here, the top view, and go to weight shade, and you can see I'm on the wild grass one. So I'm basically saying the wild grass layer, I want it just in this area. You've got the waterbed if I want to put stones there. I want trees at the back part, and then all over the main area I want it to be covered in grass. So what I've done is, like I said, is just used the points option and the right mouse click to select these areas and go down to the bottom here, click on the W and make new weight maps. If you don't want the weight maps, you can right mouse click on them, rename or delete them or copy them and so on. So once I've got this, what I'm going to do is save it, and I'm just going to send it through to layout. And here we go. When I brought my land in from Mudbox, it was quite, it was a lot bigger than I needed. So I reduced the land size roughly to what I wanted the trees to be. So I want the trees to be this size, so the actual stream isn't too big, it's just one that you can probably jump over if you're a person. So if you notice as well, all my items, if I just go to scene editor, they're all centered in my scene. When you use instancing, what it usually does, it uses the center point of your large of the main grid with a black lines going through, and it uses wherever the actual object is positioned over it. So I've just actually placed them on or very slightly below the main center of my actual area. So once I've done that, everything apart from my land I'm gonna turn off. Let's turn the land back on like so, because even though I'm going to be using the actual different grasses and rocks and stuff, you don't need to see them. So, and I also don't want them stuck out in all on top of each other in the middle of my scene. So let's just move this light out of the way for the time being. Let me just turn on VPR. So I'm just using the basic gradient as well for this. I'm not bothered about setting up a light or anything for the time being. And the actual land I made in Mudbox took me literally about 2 minutes to do it, so it's not great, but I just wanted something to represent the land that had some kind of texture on it. Okay, so we'll start by selecting the actual land. Then at the bottom here, I'm going to go to properties and then go along to the last tab where it says instancing, and then we're going to add an instance generator and then double click the setting. So what we've got is this. So currently at the top here, look, says instance generator, my actual project's called trees for some reason, and then the object I've got is land. So I'm actually adding objects to my land, so you have to select the object you want to add the instances to. So from add object, here's all the different objects. So I'm going to click tree one, double click it. Here, look, you've got some options. You can actually choose the actual different outline of what the object will be, because if you've got, like, say I'm going to have different trees and different rocks and different stuff, so you can give them a their own color, and obviously you can see them in OpenGL how you want it. So we'll say we'll just have it like this, and then what I'm going to do is, where it says generation, I'm going to tell it to attach to the surfaces, and let's put in, say, we'll start with 100, like so. And so what it's done, it's generated 100 over this whole surface. At the bottom here, it's a scale, because I don't want them all to be the same scale. Let's randomize them from, say, 70 to 120. So they're actually between the size of 70% and 120 of the original object. I'm going to leave, you can stretch them out if you want, but I'm not going to do that. Offset them from the original position, I'm not going to do that. If you do under rotation, which says alignment, currently they're aligned to the actual ground plane straight up. But if you clicked on normals, what this does, based on how your polygons are sculpted and rotated, they'll align them up in the same way that they put the actual normals, which is the center of the polygon, is sticking out. For this one, I'm just going to leave it as items. And what we do want to do is go to node, and we're going to use a node editor and click edit node. The reason we're doing this is because we're going to use a weight map. So when it comes up, your node editor, if you just click in the little search box, just put WE, it'll come up with weight map. Double click it and you plug in the value into the weight. Everything will disappear because you need to choose a weight. And then here it says weight map. I'm going to choose back tree. So I made a selection in modeler to make this weight map and made them at the back like so. So I just want them all to be like that on the back tree for this. Let's just turn on VPR. Let's have a look what it looks like. And again, I'm just using this the basic light setup. I'm not changing anything at all. So as you can see, I mean, if you, there's what? I know I put 100 in, but it's based on the area. So things I'm going to do first is, just so I speed this up, I'm just going to turn adaptive sampling off and put something like 4 in minimum samples. I'm also going to go to the render tab, render properties, and change a few settings. So I'm going to click on enable despeckle, put that down to 0.2. I'm going to click on noise filter to GPU, and then where it says polygon interaction mode, put it to fastest. For global illumination, we're going to put it, say, 6, and that'll do. And that'll just speed your VPR up for you a little bit, as you can see. And the faster your graphics card, or if you've got a faster CPU, you could choose that instead. It does look slightly blurred, but I'm only using it to work on my VPR. I'm not going to use it in my final render. I just want it to speed up the actual render process and stuff. So yeah, let's turn that off. So let's go and do another generator. So what I could do is I could double click and add some more here, but I just find there's more control over your actual generators if you just keep adding new ones. I prefer to do that, but it's anyone, it's up to you what you kind of do. So I'm on the land again. Let's do tree two. Let's do exactly the same. We'll just surface, what did we say, let's do 100. We'll randomize the scale from 50 to 100. We're using the node. It'll bring up the last one we used. Plug the value into weight, double click it. And again, we're using the tree back. So it's the back area here. So we're adding two trees now. Let's have a look. So it should be getting slightly more busier with trees. Now, based on how high or so this or the other tree was, what you can do is go down here and change the scale if you wish. Could go to 150, we'll make it a lot bigger. these other trees as well, and they might be over the top or inside each other because you're using the same weight map. So you can go to offset and you can move them if you wish, move them around like so. Look, and don't worry if it goes over the top of this. Land, I'm imagining that the land's a lot bigger than this, so you wouldn't kind of see it. So you've got like different trees again there. So let's do another one. Add a generator. Shut this down. This time let's add some grass. Double click, we're adding it to the surface. Let's put in, let's go 5,000 this time. And the scale, let's say the grass is roughly between 50 and 125. Just making this up, to be honest. This time under rotation, I'm going to tell the grass to be against the normal, so it follows the contours of the polygons. Go to node, we're using node. Add the weight map, plug value into value. Double click, and this time I've got a grass, so now it's staying just on the grass, so it stayed out of the bank as well. Let's have another look. As you can see, so now we've got grass everywhere covering where we have made the selections of the grass and so on. And again, if I mean at this stage I've put the, let's go back to here and turn off, let's turn this off. There we go. So we don't, we're not using the GPU, we're using the CPU. If you had CPUs, okay, it'd be fine. It's just not going to give you that blurredness to it, like so. And yeah, you can come in anytime. You can go back to here and add more instances, play about with the size, the rotation. Again, I've not done anything with the rotation, so if you wanted to rotate the trees around randomly as well, so they're not all rotate the same way, you can. Let's just add one more. There's lots of others in here that I can use, but if I just go to add one more, this time let's add the rock. I've got one rock in here. I should have had more than one, really. Follow the same, let's put 150 rocks. Let's tell the scale to be from 30% to 150%. Let's use a node. We can change this, some of the settings after. Let's plug it in, and this time let's make it to the waterbed. So because I've got like a weight map for the waterbed, so what it'll do is add stones roughly on the waterbed. So what other things we could do here is maybe we could tell these ones to be against the normals as well. So you kind of random stones everywhere. So if there's water coming, there's no water in here at the minute, but if water was coming down, there would, there's different stones, and you could have different stones with different textures on as well. I mean, let's increase that to something like 300. So there's even more stones going through, like so. And then you can simply just make a basic shape for polygons and put a basic water texture on here. And again, you can randomly rotate them in different ways. It's again, you just got to play around with it, get the scene you want and stuff. And again, offset, you can drag them along and turn them around and so on. But yeah, that's how easy it is. You just literally, you don't have to use weight maps, but the thing is, if this didn't have a weight map on, you'd have no control of where the assets you want would sit. So this just gives you extra control over the actual positioning of some of the instancing at a kind of very basic level. But you can see why just me playing around with three or four assets over a basic ground plane, that you can produce something that's quite nice very quickly. I mean, I would come in here and maybe add some bushes and some wildflowers, add some water, nice sky, and before you know it, you've got a nice little scene. So that's the basics of using weight maps with instancing, and I've hoped it helps you. See you next time.